At the Alliance for Social Equity and Public Accountability, ASEPA, civil society organization has brought this to the fore. Adam Senanu is a co-chair of the Citizens Movement Against Corruption. Mr. Senanu, good evening to you. Thank you for your time this evening. This particular issue of seconding a deputy attorney, that's an auditor general, to take an office in an entity where that has to be edited by the same unit. What's your reaction to this?
Well, there are very legitimate concerns about the potential conflict of interest. And I think that Mr. Winfield is a professional, seasoned, and very knowledgeable. I think that the right thing would be for him to not be on secondment. He should actually just move on there, because the single most important government entity that is audited is the Ministry of Finance, in terms of its dealings with all the other agencies and MDAs. And so to ensure that he does not get himself into that position, which is a legitimate concern for others, and will draw a lot of criticism, he should just relinquish the position he has at the moment at Auditor General. If the coach believes that he can play a better role in the Ministry of Finance, then they should just redeploy him there and take off that other role of being an auditor or playing a role within the audit ambit.
But, you know, Mr. Senanu, I'm thinking the coach knows this person is occupying a specific position now as a deputy auditor general. And then the coach still decides to second him to the most audited ministry. I mean, this, as you say, is in the face of it, it's a clear case of conflict of interest. I mean, why would the coach, in this instance, the government or the presidency, do this?
Well, that will be speculative. You don't know, I don't know, none of the rats were there when they took their decision. The most important thing is that it is clearly a conflict of interest when he gets there and still has a role from the audit function in that entity. And to that extent, in order not to create the impression that this is intentional, which is what others may begin to think, make sure that he is excluded from playing an audit function at the same time as being part of those who are responsible for executing and expending government resources. That is what is going to create a problem. And so government be minded by that and take the necessary steps to either decide that he is a bookkeeper, in which case he's at audit function protecting our goal, or if he's going to be a striker, he cannot play both roles. And if you move him, then you have an empty goal and we're in trouble. So let's not create a problem for ourselves by insisting that he plays both roles.
Right. But there's no precedence to this situation. I mean, from what you know, there hasn't been a situation like this before
in the past where a deputy auditor general... It would not be, from corporate governance, from all the other professional ethics you would know, this will not be one of those kind of things that will be supported.
I appreciate your time.